watching right now. We're taking a closer look at NATO forces. They're fighting back against a rather bold daylight attack by Taliban insurgents in Afghanistan. One of the main targets, the United States Embassy in Kabul, which is now on lockdown. Let's turn to our Pentagon correspondent, Barbara Starr. She's watching the story. A brazen daylight attack. What's the latest, Barbara?
Well, you know, Wolf, the U.S. and NATO like to say that the Taliban attacks aren't very effective. Today, the Taliban took NATO and the U.S. on straight on. Under fire from brazen insurgents in a nearby building, NATO forces shot back from the top of their headquarters inside one of the most secure areas of Kabul. Fighting raged for hours as insurgents launched small arms and rocket-propelled grenades to attack not just NATO, but also the nearby U.S. embassy, the power centers of the U.S.-led war effort.
A handful of individuals, five or so, perhaps wearing suicide vests, were able to move into a building that's under construction several hundred meters from the embassy.
At least four sites in Kabul were attacked. Three Afghan police officers killed, several Afghans injured. There were no U.S. casualties.
We will take all necessary steps, not only to ensure the safety of our people, but to secure the area and to ensure that those who perpetrated this attack are dealt with.
U.S. officials tell CNN they had intelligence that insurgents were preparing to attack Kabul around the 10th anniversary of 9/11. CNN's Suzanne Malveaux reporting from Kabul says the insurgents had an impact.
The grenades and the weapons did not actually penetrate the embassy and some of these other very important buildings, the presidential palace and so forth, but they are striking at the heart of this powerful community and the security inside of this community, and that has had a devastating psychological effect.
The Pentagon sought to downplay the impact of the attack, but in his first public hearing as CIA director, David Petraeus warned very real threats remain in the region.
Even with its core leadership having sustained significant losses, however, Al-Qaeda and its affiliates still pose a very real threat that will require our energy, focus, creativity, and dedication. Al-Qaeda's operatives remain committed to attacks against U.S. citizens at home and overseas.
And there are new questions once again about whether the CIA is going too far in protecting Americans. This all came up at the hearing. General Petraeus, now Director Petraeus, saying that the CIA Inspector General is reviewing the role of a CIA officer now working with the New York Police Department to see if that program is appropriate. Wolf?
Thanks very much.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
HillaryClinton.com.